Consistent and never-ending self-improvement is the only way. I was not good at writing even compositions or essays at school. However, as a narrator, I have been gifted with this rare ability to present even the most complex wisdom in the simplest of forms. I can conceptualize even the most intriguing truths of life and teach them in a language that anyone can understand. Basically, I have content value on life and living, so I decided to give writing a shot. But who would publish my writing? So I decided to publish a magazine. That's how Frozen Thoughts came into existence. The first time I wrote for Frozen Thoughts in the year 2000, I must confess that even I did not enjoy reading my own article. Soon I realized my English grammar was not good either. A reader hurled the first issue of Frozen Thoughts at me and screamed, "Disgusting and complex sentence formations, lousy language, terrible grammar, cheap jokes, gaudy color combinations and hundreds of spelling mistakes. This magazine is worth my foot." Hurt can be a major source of inspiration, and to me it was. If you throw a dagger at me, I will catch it by the handle and not by the blade. Now, that dagger becomes an additional weapon in my arsenal. A situation becomes an opportunity when the resources you have are greater than the situation you face. I saw an opportunity. Luck is the meeting point of all opportunities that pass by you and your alertness to grab them. I decided to author my luck, so I put a team together to overcome these issues. You don't have to be all that intelligent. If you know how to surround yourself with enough intelligent people, I built an intelligent team around me. You need to know the subject to level in the subject. So I started working on my writing, got back to learning the fundamentals of grammar, set out to learn design and technology, did everything that was needed to qualify myself for the responsibility. I am not saying that editing, publishing and distributing a magazine is very complicated, but I found it complicated because I didn't have the requisites to execute the responsibilities. A situation is considered a challenge when the situation you face is larger than the resources you have. My plight was that I had a challenge at hand. It was not good enough for the chair I assumed. So I had to commit myself to consistent and never-ending self-improvement. I got better at everything I had to get better at. There are no stagnant responsibilities. They are dynamic. So your personal growth has to keep pace with it. Being the editor is not a crown given to me, but a responsibility that I have undertaken. Today, Frozen Thoughts enjoys global readership in over 65 countries and in over 450 locations in India. Today, it is heartwarming to know that nobody will throw a copy of Frozen Thoughts. It is even more gratifying to know that this unposted letter book you are holding in your hand is born from the womb of Frozen Thoughts. Today's challenge is that the role of a person assumes is growing faster than the person. Efficiency and effectiveness happens when man keeps up with the pace of growth of his roles. Consistent and never-ending self-improvement is the only way. Nobody succeeds all the time. Nobody is destined to remain a failure either. Success is failure delayed, and failure is success delayed. Neither a failure final nor is success permanent. Today's success and today's failures are just another step in the long journey of life. Life is a game. If you play this game long enough, you will make it. Don't quit midway. Play to the end. Play it long enough. Eventually, you will cross the finishing line. When was the last time I did something for the first time? For most people, life is a repetitive drill. Waking up at the same time, struggling in bed for a few minutes before getting up, brushing the same way, drinking the same coffee, reading the same newspaper, a time-bound bath, a hurried breakfast, road race on the way to work, same office, same work, gossip and lunch, same talk, same road back to home, same mega serial, same arguments, compulsive dinner, same bed, crash out and wake up another time to another day to the same drill. Life did not be mundane. Life need not be boring. Life need not be a year's experience repeated n number of times. Life need not be an imposition. Life need not be a life imprisonment. There is more to life than existing. Pursue a new proficiency every year and see how exciting life can be. Let there not be a phase in your life when you are not enrolled as an active student. It could be music lessons, playing instruments, dance classes, alternative medicine, new fitness regimes, yoga, new languages, advanced grammar, creative writing, public speaking, cooking classes, painting, handwriting, new art forms, driving, swimming, a new sport, technical education, spiritual study groups, gardening, raising pet birds and animals, keeping an aquarium, photography, culture. The list is truly endless. Choose any and remain an active student. Always be an explorer of life. Keep experimenting. Keep trying. Feed your curiosity and inquisitiveness. Keep attempting something that has not been attempted before. Try out new cuisines. Wear clothes you are shy of wearing. Try a new hairstyle. Visit unusual places. Men, run the kitchen for a day. Have a husband's get together on a Sunday and serve the wives. Spend a day blindfolded. Go on voice rest another day. Use public transport for a day. Switch roles at your workplace. How about the MD at the reception for the day? Again, the list is endless. Get creative with life. Keep going. More than all your successes, achievements, and accomplishments, the formula to a lively life is to keep answering this question: when was the last time I did something for the first time? Celebrate life. Stamp your presence on every day of your life. Spell life with L-I-F-E. Be excited to be alive. Less will make it long. More will make it short. It is commonly observed phenomenon to see organizations grow very fast and then crumble even faster than that. Ask people who have burned their fingers in the stock market by investing on such companies and the hordes of others who have lost all their money on such finance companies. They will have tearful tales to tell you. Of course, it is also not uncommon to see organizations that take time to build their base, establish business models, get their fundamentals right, put systems and infrastructure in place. These organizations, though slow in their initial progress, keep growing in geometric progression over the years. Ask people who have amassed assets by investing on such technically sound companies. They will have success stories to tell you. Rome was not built in a day, goes the saying. If Rome was built in a day, it would have fallen the next day. Even in the case of relationships, I have observed that relationships where people get obsessed with each other within a short span of time break up over a single misunderstanding, a single incident, a single argument. Only relationships that gain strength, confidence, transparency, and intimacy over a period of time develop the stability and depth required to stand the test of time. Which will have greater stability, a cone standing on its base or an inverted cone? It takes time to set the base right. Might as well invest time in the beginning to get the base right rather than spending time later to keep correcting the mess. You say, I like eating. Precisely for the same reason, eat less. Then you will live long enough to eat. You say, I like sleeping. Precisely for the same reason, sleep less. Then you will live long enough to sleep. You say, I love him a lot. Precisely for the same reason, give him space. You say, I want to hit the top. Precisely for the same reason, invest enough time at the bottom to build the base. Then the base will sustain you at the top. Less will make it long. More will make it short.